Yes, he did.
He's got it. Pole position for Arbolino. What a lap for him. Arbolino with back-to-back podiums in second. But it's Tony Arbolino with the biggest win of his life. Time for Q2 in Moto3. Across the line by Raul Fernandez, who gets a 48.6, which is a stonking lap time. Tony Arbolino is on a charge. He's up in sector 3.
Tony Arbolino goes top, 148.566.
Raul Fernandez, speciality on a Saturday afternoon, is a good lap time from Raul, and he's delivering one right now. He's 0.06 of a second up in sector 2, and Darren Binder just behind him as well. Really impressive from Raul Fernandez as he comes across the line here now. He posts a 48.380. That's a new lap record.
He's down Arbolino over the line.
No,
didn't happen.
Yes, he did. 47.7.
The transponder was a little bit late.
He's got it. Pole position for Arbolino. What a lap for him. His sixth pole position and a new all-time lap record for Tony Arbolino. And as we start the final lap of the race and our return to racing, it will be John McPhee that leads them across the line from Arbolino.
Arbolino moves out of the slipstream around the outside of John McPhee. Look at McPhee running a tight defensive line, but Arbolino's got him around the outside.
Arbolino runs look at McPhee! Line.
McPhee, has he got it stopped? Has he run a little bit wide? He's run too wide, and Arena sweeps him. Oh, McPhee's down! Arenas is going to win surely. McPhee's down the final corner.
Arenas makes it back-to-back wins in 2020. He takes glory here on home turf. Ayagura pinches second place. Tony Arbolino third.
Look at McPhee up the inside of Arbolino. He was wide. Yeah, it was Vietti that sort of gave Arbolino a little bit of a nudge. That momentum pushed him out wide, and poor old John McPhee had absolutely nowhere to go.
Here comes Arbolino. They're aggressive. Up into second place. That's brilliant from Arbolino. Started seventh. Jam Amassi and Tony Arbolino power through to first and second. And who's going to get the lead? Which is there? Contact, I think. What a moment. What drama here in this Moto3 World Championship. Here comes Alberto Reynas up the inside of Tony Arbolino into turn two. And Arbolino was really wide. Brilliant move that from Tony Arbolino. So Massi's down to fourth. We're getting closer to the final lap. Is there a few twists and turns to come? That was aggressive and brilliant from Arbolino. He moves up to second. Arbolino with back-to-back podiums in second. Great start for Arbolino. He's made up 8 places on the first half of this lap already. He's up to 19th. Hats off Arbolino, 11 places made up now, and you can actually see him at the back of this front group. Incredible start.
Arbolino trying to find a way through on Darren Binder, and he's found a way through. So that's another position gain for Arbolino then, back inside. Well, now he's up to 9. Brilliant job by Arbolino. He found half a second on Agüero on that last lap. Look at this. Agüero is about to be swallowed up by Tony Arbolino, who's come from 27th place on the grid.
But he's going to the outside. He pulls alongside Alberto Reynas. Reynas will try and block pass into turn one.
Reynas, just nothing he could do about that.
Here we go then. Arbolino takes fifth. And what a job from Arbolino. Yeah. You have to give him an enormous amount of credit. He has come through from 27th on the grid to finish in fifth place today and wraps up second in the World Championship. Arbolino then with that move into second would be 16 down on the World Championship leader Arenas going into the final round next week. Here comes Arbolino then, he's attacking and he's through and he leads the Grand Prix of Valencia with just 2 laps remaining. As we cross the line, the last lap of the race here in Valencia, what a final 4 kilometres this is going to be for Tony Arbolino and his World Championship hope.
Looks like it's going to be Tony Arbolino to take the biggest win of his Grand Prix career.
But it's Tony Arbolino with the biggest win of his life. Tony Arbolino, take a bow. That was class from the River Cold Snipers rider. His first win of 2020. And of course, let's not forget, crucially, had to sit out race 1 in Aragon.
Hey YouTube, I'm Joe Robert. I just ate some.
Do you want water?
Yeah, you have some water? I just ate some almonds. Hey YouTube, I'm Joe Roberts. If you like this video, don't forget to give us a big thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel.